I was in Poundworld. Emphasis on Poundworld. Because this is the third tick, because I keep saying Poundland. No, Poundworld. And I found this lovely contraption. It was £4. And it says on the bottom, oh, I should say what it is. Read LearnPad, interactive learning toy, it says. I've already looked for all these words, and they're all spelt correctly so far. On the bottom it says, interactive learning toy available in blue or pink. 32 words to learn, 2 songs, 10 pianos, sound number keys. Okay. Spelling, mathematics, music and learning. On the back is that always, as ever, the excellent sign of quality. It's just borrowed on what colour I'm expected to find in here. And they've ticked blue. Blue and pink available. Mm. Let's get this open. It says it takes 3 AA batteries, which I've got on standby. Now, true Poundworld quality, one of these had already been ravved open and slung on the shelf. Obviously someone expecting to find like a proper iPad or something inside, I don't know. I don't know what they're trying to find. It just says the same thing on the, look, it's just the same thing on all the sides. Let's get this open and we'll see what's inside. So what is it? Well, see, it's not really blue at all, is it? It's white. It's just a little plastic bit. So this is blue. It's a bit bubbly. I don't know if you can see that on the camera, but it's all bubble. Oh, there you go. There's a good view. It's all like bubbled up. It's like, that's very plasticky. I mean, £4. Bearing in mind, it was just £4. So this is what the blue means. I mean, it's a bit false because you'd assume that the whole thing was blue, but it's not. It's white. Let's get some batteries in here. I've already looked at all this. Is it the same as the box? Yeah, everything is actually spelt right so far. Anyone who knows me, I've got a particular thing about how this letter is pronounced. And since it's so cheap, I'm expecting this letter to be mispronounced as well. Oh, good grief. That is really tacky. Let's get a screwdriver in this. It says it's suitable for ages 3 and up. Now this looks like it's got 2 speakers in, but it hasn't. There's a speaker in there, but not that sad. Oh, look, they've even bothered to put these on. That's a feature. Does it actually work? Does it actually solve anything? It's still quite slidey. Yeah, for ages 3 and up, this is. Now, fortunately, good grief, the clicks down a bit more abruptly than what I thought they would. I'll just get my Poundland screwdriver set and we'll get into there because they don't want kids to choke on batteries, apparently. It says it takes 3 AA's, but this is quite a small door for 3 AA's. Look, it says there, look, 3 AA's. This door looks... I mean, I've got 3 AA's here. I mean, I would have got... Is it 3 AA's? Are they going to fit in there? I'm going to find that out, aren't we? I'm not expecting VTech quality sound chips in this or anything like that. I can't even get this open. It's just refusing. Oh, here we go. See, for the price, I didn't want to chew the screwdriver up. And, oh yeah, it is. Oh, wow, look at that. You can even see the chipboard through the battery pack. God, that's a really tight fit for them batteries. 1, 2. I'm expecting the sound to be brutal. Is it going to turn on straight away? No, it didn't. I was expecting it to go like a squeaky noise or something. Right, I'm not going to bother to put the screw back in. Right, so, oh. Yeah, I think I'm going to have to be bothered to put the screwdriver back in because that door is not staying on. Wow, quality. That was a joke. It's not quality. Right, has that screw gone back in? Yes. Excuse my snuffling, by the way. I'm still getting over the flu. Nearly said cold. It knocked me out for 3 days. Right, let's get all this tat out of the way. Shall we get rid of it? Wait, where's the on button? There it is. It's not working.
Hello! Ah!
Right, the on button was there, but you've got to turn it on there, apparently. Oh, God, you can even see the chipboard through the... Not the chipboard, the... Well, yeah. The microchip board, isn't it? Through the lights. Four lights we've got.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Hello.
Hello.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Hello.
Hello. Right, let's see what... see where it does. I'm going to press number one. Breaking it already. No, I'll press A for Apple. It's not doing out. Letter, maybe I've got to press letter mode. It's not doing out.
Hello.
Oh. Okay, so you got to turn it on, then you got to turn it on again, apparently. Letter mode. What are you doing? Has everything just got a jingle?
A.
Oh, here we go. Let's see if she pronounces everything. A.
B.
B.
C.
C.
A.
D.
A.
What?
A. A. A.
E. Apparently.
F.
F.
H.
G.
H.
Yay! She says H.
H.
H. See, everybody, it is. No matter where you are in the world, it's a... H.
I.
I.
J.
J.
K.
K.
L.
L.
M.
M.
N. N. N.
N. What sort of accent is this?
O.
O.
T. 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 T.
Right, that's meant to be P, but it sounds like she's saying T. W.
X.
X.
Y.
Y. Now she says Z. Instantly, Poundworld, you can just get out. If she says Z, she can go. I'm going to just be very, very cross. Oh, the suspense.
Z.
Ah, I knew it. I knew it. Flipping a load of tats. What's a load of tats? It is not.
Z.
It's Z. Z. It's bloody Poundworld for you, do you know what I mean? I knew it was going to say that. I just knew it was... Z. So instantly, it's teaching your kids wrong. Right.
Duck.
Duck.
Frog.
Frog.
Sheep.
Sheep.
Milk.
Milk.
Hot dog.
Hot dog.
Hamburger.
Hamburger. And what others? Whatever. So there's that. Word mode. I think in that some American-esque sort of nursery rhyme, like Bingo was his name or something, I don't know.
Apple.
Apple.
Bear.
Bear.
Cap.
Well, that sounded a lot like cat rather than cap.
Cap. Cap. Dinner.
Dinner.
Egg.
Egg.
Fish. Fish. Fish.
That's a very weird pronunciation of the word fish. I think the voice person somewhere between Chinese and American. Maybe it's someone who's Chinese who's learned English from an American.
Gift.
Gift.
Horse. Apple. Orange. Notebook. Monkey. Lunch. Kite. Juice. Ice cream.
waiter. I think it's got a T in there, love. I think it's a waiter, not a waiter. Waiter.
Waiter, waiter, waiter.
Waiter, waiter, waiter.
X-ray.
Well, a very original X-ray for X.
Yo-yo. Zebra.
Zebra. Zebra. Zebra. Not zebra and zebra. Oh, no, there's so many Americans now telling me this out my little, but the point of the fact is I bought this in England, London, not America. What is it? Okay then, this is doing the noises of animals. Sounds like the Jaws theme tune, doesn't it? It's just like... Oh, it's doing it twice now. Sheep being strangled. Well, what noise does milk gonna make? Sounds like someone having diarrhea on the loo. Oh, I shouldn't have had that entire box of chocolates. Oh, after my box of chocolates, I shouldn't have eaten all that sweet chili chicken. Oh, I have got plenty of toilet roll left. What sound does a hot dog make? What? What is that? Can I make the sound of a hot dog, please? Okay. What the hell? And what sound does a hamburger make? Well, yeah. That is so stupid. Spell mode. Oh, here we go. Wow, the sound, it is so loud. Right, so this is spell mode. So what's it going to do, spell?
One, O, N, E, 1, 2, 3, T, H, R, E, E, 3.
I just get a point because it's saying the letter H properly. In this that it's American probably spelling apart from zebra.
Zebra. Z-E-B-R-A. Zebra.
I think I know how to spell zebra, thank you very much. I think I know how to say it as well. I think the problem with this as well, because the sound quality is so poor and so loud, the first part of this word just sounds wrong. Oh, let's see if it can spell yo-yo.
Yo-yo. Y-O.
I think that's the sound of why I bought this, really. Why did I buy this?
Why
did I buy this? What are the... Oh, this is a long word for it to spell.
Umbrella. U-M-B-R-E-L-L-A. Umbrella.
I don't know if it's going to spell extra. I wonder if it's going to say the hyphen. Yeah, I didn't say that, I didn't mention the hyphen. ABC number song. Oh, here we go. What's this noise? What the hell was that? What? Off at the end. That just reminds me of Stewie Griffin in Family Guy when he forgets his letters in the alphabet, because I couldn't hear any of the letters in that. It just sounded like
one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine,
I've just realised I pressed that button again, and once again I forgot to warn you about turning your headphones down or earphones, depending on which ones. I'm sorry, everybody. That was terrible. What is music? The tune reminds me of something. Is that it? Good. Yeah, if you really dislike someone, get them this as a present. What's the other one? I think they said there was two songs, didn't they? This is really irritating. You know, if you really don't like someone, get the kids this, and when the kids start playing this, it's so loud and obtrusively rude. A little loud. What else is the... What's that? Quiz plus minus. And there's ask.
Can you find the number 3?
Oh, here we go. Can I find the number 3? I want to see what happens if I press this.
6. Try again.
I will.
Find the number 3. 6. Try again. Can you find the number 3? 6. Can you find the word ice cream?
What? Well, what's the point in that? I've learned nothing. No, it's not telling me I was wrong. For all I know, that I've pressed it right. I don't even know what word it, I don't know what word it told me to look for now.
Juice. Try again. Can you find the word ice cream? Juice. Try again. Can you find the word ice cream? Juice. Can you find the letter J?
See, look, it's not giving me any... Let's see if... All right, I'll press the letter J.
J. Good. Can you find a number 10? 10. Good. Can you find a word notebook?
Is this just going to go on forever and ever?
Notebook. Good. Can you find a letter T?
Ooh. No, was that the letter T or the letter P? I want to say, I think it said T.
T. Try again. Can you find a letter T?
I said, ooh, that was not fair.
T. Good. Can you find a word gift?
Is this going to go on forever? I thought we'd be doing the best out of 10 or something. What happens if I just do it? Very riveting viewing. I can't even see the word gift. E-F-G, oh, there it is.
Gift. Good. Can you find a letter D?
Oh, God, that could be D. Is it D?
D.
Oh, God.
Good. Can you find a number 9?
The number? 9.
9.
9.
Good. Can you find a word monkey?
This isn't funny. This is never going to end. Gonna go on forever. This. Oh, that's my phone ringing. I'll have to wait. Right, now I'm gonna go on to this because that's just going on forever.
What's 3 minus 1?
Ooh, maths. 3 minus 1.
2. Good. What's 5 plus 1. 6. Good. What's 8 minus 3?
Oh gosh, 8, 7, 6, 5.
5. Good. What's 5 plus 4?
5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
9. Good. What's 4 minus 1? 3.
She's going to go on forever.
What's 8 plus 1? 9.
Giving me a headache now. This is so loud. Kids can't play this, surely. The parents are going to kill them. This is a method to kill kids. That's actually quite a good thing. Oh, look. There's some more quality for you. Look, you can see the lights through the back and through the clips. So if I was to turn the lights off. Ooh, got a lovely blue glow. Even if I turn this one off as well. Ah. You can't play this in the dark. It's turned into a stealth game. Let's see if we can do it in the dark. This is the grown-ups version. Okay, let's go for... I can only just barely see it myself. Oh, no, not shut up singing. Oh, no, press the wrong... spell mode. Right. And I need that quiz thing back. I need the quiz thing.
Can you find a word queen?
No! I can't find the word queen! Right, it was numbers across the top, wasn't it? So, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q!
Queen!
Yes! Yay!
Can you find a letter A?
Letter A? Oh, that's easy.
A! Good! Can you find a number 5?
No. Well, I can, but I can't be bothered. So, yeah, the amazing feature of having to turn it on twice is something, isn't it?
Bye-bye!
Bye-bye! Then you got to turn it off as well.
Bye-bye!
Oh, I don't know why you got to turn it on twice.
Hello!
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 Hello! And then that's that. So what do you get for your £4? Well... if you turn the lights off, you've got your own mystery board there. It's very, very plasticky and very, very thin. I don't think this is going to last very long at all for any 3-year-old, because I'm sure, yeah, these just come off as easy as that. I didn't even have to use any force for that, so they're broken off already. So they're going to get lost. It says it's English phonetic chart. Well... as we've discovered, you know, she says...
A.
I mean, it should be Z. But she does say...
H.
Correctly. There you go, for £4. I don't know, maybe you are going to think this is an amazing piece of technology. Just spins round. I'm spinning around, move out of my way. Anyway, thanks for watching. Would you buy this for your kid? Would you buy this for your brat? Would you buy this to annoy a parent with? I think I would buy it to annoy a parent with. £4, though. And no instruction book to speak of. No. So the spelling on the packaging. Please want to keep this bag away from babies and children. Not use in... ah, there we go. I knew there had to be some terrible Chinglish writing somewhere. Not use in cots, prams, buggies, beds or playpens. So that made no sense. That was terrible writing there. And there's everything else like the onion. And this product uses 3AA batteries. Not included. But everything else seems to be written pretty well. I'm going to end the video there. Thanks for watching. Please scrass. And I'm just going to say...